Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I am Adhemaditya Prayoga.
And I'm Kinanti Kartika Siwi.
We are from SMA Pradita Dirgantara. We are the one of KoPSI 2021 finalists with our research entitled
Solar Lamp Air Purifier, Lampu Penjernih Udara Berbasis Bioteknologi Mikroalga dan Analisis Efektivitasnya.
Technological developments have an impact on increasing human needs, one of which is in the field of transportation. However, most of today's transportation still uses fossil fuels as its power. In addition, technological developments also have an impact on increasing world electrical energy production. Both of those problems have an impact on increasing the Earth's carbon dioxide levels. The increasing levels of carbon dioxide on the Earth can cause various health problems in humans. Furthermore, why did we choose Chlorella species? Chlorella species is one of the biological agents that can be easily found and able to absorb carbon dioxide well. Unfortunately, Chlorella species has not been widely used by the community.
Therefore, we have an idea to make an air purifier lamp that is environmentally friendly using Chlorella species so that it can overcome the two problems that have been stated before. The tool is called SLAP, which stands for Solar Lamp Air Purifier.
There are two problem formulations in this research. The first one, how is the construction SLAP? And the second one, can SLAP reduce the carbon dioxide level in the air? The purposes of this research are constructing SLAP and then testing and analyzing its performance.
The tools and materials used in this research are
Chlorella species, aquarium, 12-volt battery, solar cell, 12-volt LED lamp, blue and red, NYAF cable, black and blue, solar charge controller, plywood, switch, CO2 temperature and humidity detector, ZN2CO1.
The process of making
slab is started. The solar panel in the circuit will convert solar energy into electrical energy. Then the current and voltage will be adjusted by the solar charge controller to match with the battery capacity. The electrical energy stored in this battery can be used to turn on the lamp that provides light spectrum to support microalgae photosynthesis in no sunlight condition. After that, we develop a body with material that we already mentioned before.
This is how to use slab. You can just put the slab in place you want to purify. For night use, press the switch on so that the LED lamp can turn on so that the Chlorella species has enough light to do photosynthesis. To charge the battery on the slab, put the slab in direct sunlight. To test whether slab can reduce carbon dioxide levels or not, we conducted a slab performance test using the carbon dioxide temperature and humidity detector, ZN2CO1.
Following are the results of performance tests in the form of data regarding carbon dioxide level in the air before and after being given concept treatment.
Based on the data obtained, we conducted an analysis using a parametric inferential statistical approach in the form of PD0113 test. Therefore, the data obtained must be proven to be normally distributed.
However, the result of several normality tests shows that the data we got is not normally distributed, as indicated by the significance value is under 5%. So, we try to give some treatment to this data in the form of outlier deletion and data malformation. However, the result is still the same, which is the significant value that we got is still under 5%. Therefore, we decided to use an alternative method of priority test, which is a non-parametric inferential approach called Wilcoxon test.
Wilcoxon test result shows that the significance value is less than 5%. Therefore, it can be concluded that SLAP can reduce carbon dioxide levels in the air significantly and effectively.
So, from this research, there are two conclusions can be drawn. The first one, the construction of SLAP can be done by using microalgae as bioagent and electrical circuit powered by solar energy that produce a light spectrum to support the microalgae photosynthesis. And the second one, SLAP can reduce the carbon dioxide level in the air.
There are some situations that we can conclude from this research. Firstly, future researchers are expected to examine more sources and references regarding the plural species related to biotechnology. Secondly, future researchers are expected to take more sample data, thereby increasing the possibility for the data to be normally distributed so that the parametric inferential approach can be carried out.
That's all from our research.
Thank you for watching this video.
Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.